All right, it's 5 minutes past two, and that means that I'll get started. Maybe some participants will join later on, but that's not a problem. But for now, I'd just like to get started. Very warm welcome to the VU Prep Campus Statistics 2020. My name is Bas de Jong. I'm a teacher at the VU and also still a master's student, just like you guys. I'm doing the business administration master and then the specialization leadership and change management, but I've been a statistics teacher at the VU now for quite a long time. I started off doing small seminars and now I'm a full grown lecturer. So I give statistics lectures up to 250 students at the same time. And I've also been asked to do this summer campus because when you guys are from three faculties, the Faculty of Social Science, the School of Business and Economics, and the Movements and Psychology faculty with some of the research masters from psychology. A very warm welcome to all of you who now joined me. Around a total of 100 students participate throughout this whole prep course. And I can see that 30 of you are now present, which I think is quite good. I think you can watch though. I'll make sure that this meeting does get recorded. So if you are on vacation or if you are at work, it doesn't matter whether you can really join or not. But I do recommend getting into these meetings because this is the most direct way to ask questions. While otherwise, if you're not present, then you can only watch it back and then you can't ask live questions. So, but today will just be an introductory episode. Once again, welcome to those of you. Most of you will be starting your masters after the summer break, so in September, and then during the second semester of this year, then you will be working on your thesis, so on your master thesis. And for most studies, it applies that you can do two types of master theses, that you can choose the qualitative track. So that will be mostly interviews and more talking with people, or that you can do the more quantitative approach. And that is that you do a survey and then do all the data analysis via SPSS and via R. And especially for the second track, this statistics course is really helpful because once you start working on your thesis, you'll need to have a basic understanding of statistics. The eventual analyses you will do for your thesis will be via SPSS, but it is of importance that you got the understanding of what you are doing in SPSS. You can't do an independent samples t-test in SPSS if you don't know how it works. And the easiest way of understanding how it works is just by learning the manual statistics. And that's why we are offering this course for the VU, for VU students from the three faculties, as a way in which you can refreshen your statistics, or even if some of you come from abroad, I noticed that there are a lot of foreign students who take part in this course, and that might mean that the VU already offers statistics throughout all the bachelor courses. But in some other countries, the statistics level is maybe a little bit lower, or they have been focusing on different statistical topics. And this is a good way for you guys to get to know the statistics which are required at the end of the bachelor. You should see it as something like this. It's a really short prep course. It's put into 2 weeks, and it's a basic summary of all the bachelor statistics which are offered at the VU. So in that way, when you start your master's, you will be having, if you choose a quantitative track in your master thesis, there will be a statistical course, but that statistical course requires that you have already got the knowledge which I'm teaching in this prep course. So if you follow this prep course, and your statistics should be up to date for when you start your master thesis, especially when you do a quantitative track. So we will be working throughout 2 weeks, but let me stress once again that the course is completely online, so you can work on it whenever you want. We work from the Sowieso website, which is a brilliant website. It contains all the theory, all the exercises. You can just refresh in the question, so you get a new question every single time. I think that the theory on there is brilliant. I'm the supervisor of this course, which means that I set up the course and I'll be teaching it. And I took a good look at all the theory, and I've selected the theoretical all the theory which I think is important to know. I've skipped out some parts which I think are either irrelevant or too difficult, and therefore not necessary. So I've really taken a good look at what I think is important for you guys to start your master's with. And that's come down to a total of 9 chapters, all on the SOESO page. And you can work on that whenever you want. So if you want to work on it tonight, that's fine. If you want to work on it from 9 to 5 during the day, that's also cool. If you want to start working, for example, if you are on vacation now and you only want to start working in 2 weeks' time, afterwards, that's fine as well. You can work on this whenever you want. So it's completely free. Don't stress if you can't work on it for a few days, because if you have a job, and I understand that obviously your job is your priority and you're doing this next to it, and that's not a problem at all. But do note that most of my supervision will be during these 2 weeks. If you ask a question throughout these 2 weeks, I'll try to answer it as soon as possible. While after the 2 weeks, I won't be responding straight away, because then I also get back to my studies and to my regular job at the VU as a statistics teacher. So throughout these 2 weeks, this prep course, it contains my full priority. You are free to work on it afterwards, but then I won't answer straight away. It won't take a month until I reply, but it won't be like the next minute. While throughout these 2 weeks, I do aim to answer your questions as soon as possible. Although I, from experience, I've also taught this prep course last year. And in that, I've noticed that the theory and the exercises are quite clear. I've also made sure that I've added a YouTube video to almost all the theory, because some people learn easier if it's via a video, if it's explained to them in real life. So therefore, I've made sure that statistical videos have been added to the topics. Some are from other YouTubers and some are from me. I also have my own YouTube channel, which is called BuzzPSS, which contains mostly videos about SPSS, but also some manual statistics. And some of those videos are linked in the theory of the exercise. So if you don't understand the theory, then I suggest first taking a look at the video, which is linked on top of the page, or on the bottom of the page, depends, and afterwards asking me. The easiest way to contact me is via WhatsApp. You can also find that on the SOESO course. You can read on the welcome instructions chapter, there's the WhatsApp page. And that's where I state that I mostly use WhatsApp, because it's just by far the easiest way to communicate. You're not obligated to do so, because in that way you do share your phone details and I can't ask you to. So you're not obligated to join the WhatsApp group, but I do recommend doing so, because it's just by far the easiest way. I mean, if you then send me a WhatsApp message, either private or in the group chat, I'll see it straight away, because I also always have my phone on me. Well, if you do it via the SOESO forum, then it might take me a bit longer to see, but especially throughout these 2 weeks, I'll be checking the forum a lot. But I do recommend WhatsApp, because it's just a really easy and fluent way to communicate. I think most of you already have WhatsApp, and else, even if you still have to get accustomed to it, it's a really easy way to communicate. So I do strongly suggest using that. But once again, you're not obligated to check out for yourself whether you want to or not. So there are 9 chapters in the course. Some are longer than others. For example, chapter 1 is a really long one, while chapter 2 and 3 are ridiculously short. I think that 5 until 8 are more difficult. So keep that in mind. Chapter 1 is really easy. Like, it's a lot of information, but it's the pure basics of statistics. So it should not form a problem for any of you. Probably, if it does, no worries, then I'll help you out. But 5, 6, 7, and 8 are probably a tiny bit more difficult. So take your time when doing that. In this course, there are 4 tests. If you go to the SOESO class, then you can see that there are 4 tests in the bottom right corner of your screen. And in the agenda, so in the planning for the 2 weeks, I've chosen 4 test points, which will be this Wednesday, this Sunday, next Wednesday, and next Sunday. But once again, that's not a strict deadline. You can make those tests whenever you want. But I would suggest that as a minimum. Because then they slightly align with the webinars I'll be giving this Thursday and the Thursday afterwards. So I try to make sure that you are at that pace so that you've finished chapter 1 and 2 before Wednesday, and then 3, 4, and 5 by Sunday, and then 6 and 7 next week, and 8 and 9 at the end of next week, because then they align with the webinar, so I can answer appropriate questions. But if you already want to cruise through it, like, my estimation is that this course will take about 40 hours. But if it doesn't, if it takes way shorter, for some of you, it will. Those of you who find it easier, it will take probably less than 40 hours. But if it takes more than 40 hours, if it takes less than 40 hours, and you, for example, if you've already finished chapter 1 and 2 today, then by all means, already make the test and start working on chapter 3, 4, and 5 tomorrow. I mean, there's no strict deadline. Work on it whenever you want. And even if you don't want to make the test, that's okay. The tests are not mandatory. Your teacher of next year, so your study coordinator, won't know about how you did in this course. It's merely for you. The tests are merely for self-assessment. So it's really for you to get to know whether you understood the theory or not. Even if you fail the test, it doesn't matter at all. You can just make it again. You can just take a look at your wrong answers and then start to make the test again. So it's not a problem at all. You don't need to make them. If you get stressed out by these tests, then you are not obligated to make them. That's not a problem at all. You can just skip the test then, but I do recommend making them, because that's why you would know your, because in that way, you can truly test yourself on whether you understand the skills or not. But once again, you don't need to make the test, but I do recommend doing so. There will be 2 more webinars after this one. The first one will be this Thursday at 2:00. You can already find the link to that Zoom meeting on the Sowieso page. The second webinar will be next week, Thursday, also at 2:00. And also the link, you can already find that one. This webinar is recorded. The next 2 will be as well. And I will place the recordings of this webinar on YouTube, on my YouTube channel. And then I'll link that on the Sowieso page, so you can watch back these Zoom meetings. So that should not be a problem. Furthermore, what else do I need to say? If any real problems arise, for example, if your communication with me isn't the way you'd like it to be, then first address me, first come to me, and then we'll discuss it, what's bothering you. And if something would be horribly wrong, then the contact details of my supervisor can also be found on Sowieso, but I would only do that in extreme circumstances. She's on vacation currently, so please don't approach her unless it's strictly necessary. But I don't think you'll need to, because I can't imagine why any problems would arise. But just in case, on the Sowieso page, you can find the contact details of my supervisor, just in case there's an emergency. And I think that is about it. During the next 2 webinars, it will mostly be like a Q&A. So in the group chat, you can ask specific questions, and then I'll explain them here live on Zoom via my webcam, via my microphone. And I can even share screen. So I would then, for example, share my screen to the Sowieso page, and I would discuss a live exercise in order to explain it to you. If really no questions arise, for example, last year in the first webinar, there were quite a lot of questions, while during the second webinar, there were hardly any questions, because I've made sure that the Sowieso page is of really high quality. I think that if you take a good look at the theory and practice a lot and take a look at the solutions, then it should really be doable. I've made sure personally that the Sowieso page is of a quite a high standard. Um, So if there are no, so if there are only very few questions during these webinars, then that would obviously be a very good sign, because that means that you guys understand everything. And if that were the case, then I'll explain a little bit more about how you can approach a thesis and maybe take a bit of more of a look at SPSS. Because I did that last year during the second webinar, there were hardly any questions. So then I'll just discuss a bit more about how you should approach your thesis and how SPSS works and stuff like that. But that's only for next week. Probably this first webinar, you guys will have some questions. So if you have any questions, please use the SOESO forum or ask me on WhatsApp. It doesn't need to be strictly about the statistical matters. If you want to know something about the VU or about Amsterdam itself, or have any problems with your study coordinator, or if there's anything you'd like to know, I've been a student here at the VU for over 6 years now and been a teacher here for 2 years now. So I know quite a lot of stuff about the VU. Also that they sometimes can be a pain in the ass communication-wise, but that's with every university. So if you have a question about any kind, just make sure to let me know. And this was about the end of the introduction. Are there any more questions at this point? Then this is the moment to ask it in the group chat. And my guess is that there won't be any questions, but I'll give you guys 1 minute and else we're gonna round it off for now. Agnes says, no, thank you. Well, thank you, Agnes, for letting me know. Are there any other questions? I don't think so, because it was merely the introduction. Okay. Then I would say get started with chapter. I really suggest making the chapters in a linear order. So start with chapter 1, then chapter 2, then chapter 3, because it builds up. I wouldn't get started with chapter 9. So for now, that's going to be it. I'll upload the recording in a minute to YouTube and then to the SOESO page, so you can watch this back whenever you want. And for now, guys, lots of good luck. It should be doable. I think everybody last year passed all the tests easily. I mean, if you just practice and then make the test, it should be doable. Also, feel free to make notes throughout the exercise and throughout the theory and the exercises, and then keep those notes with you during making the tests. I mean, it is not, you don't need to know every formula by heart. That's not the purpose of this course. It's not that you know everything strictly by heart, every formula, because honestly, even I don't know every formula by heart. It's important that you understand them all. So if you want to write the formulas down and then keep them with you while making the test, that's fine. That's the most important thing. The most important thing is that if you get an exercise later on in your thesis, you get a certain, you have to do something, is that you understand how to. And if that involves notes, that's totally fine. So I wish you all the very best of luck. And then I'll see you guys again on Thursday. And for now, I'm out.